boys and girls, and welcome back to Slam. So today I wanted to start off Slam a little bit differently. I was sharing the daily reflection that I read, and I just think that it's a really good prayer. So we're going to start off by reading this. This is called Run to Me. There are so many things to worry about. Did you study enough for the big test? Did your friend really mean what they said? Why can't you seem to make your parents understand? Worry can make us afraid and anxious, but we have a choice, and it's a choice that we will have to make 1,000 times every day. We have to choose whether to trust in Jesus or to worry. Choose to trust in Jesus, and He will trade our fear for His peace. Every time we choose Him over worry, He gives us more of His peace. We will never run out of things to worry about. Choose to run to Him instead. He will never run out of peace. I just thought that that was a really important prayer that we could read to start off Slam. I know that there are so many things going on in the world right now that we could worry about, and sometimes it's overwhelming. So rather than being overwhelmed and letting those create worry for us, let's give that back to Jesus, and let's trust that He's going to take care of us and He is in control. So let's talk about our gospel for this week. Jesus had been traveling around the countryside, preaching and teaching and helping the sick, and He'd become very, very popular. And everywhere He went, there were huge crowds of people. They came to hear Him talk about God's love and to be healed of their diseases. And one day, Jesus went to visit the home of Simon Peter. And when He got there, Peter's mother-in-law was sick, and she was in bed with a fever. So they told Jesus right away. And Jesus took her by the hand, He helped her up, and immediately the fever had left her. She was healed, and then she went and began to fix dinner for everyone. When the people heard that Jesus was at Peter's house, a huge crowd began to come and gather outside the door. People brought their sick friends to Jesus, and He healed many of them who had all different kinds of diseases. The next morning, Jesus woke up before anyone else. He went outside to spend some time alone with His Father in prayer. He just needed that time to rest and recharge. Later, Peter and the other disciples, they went looking for Jesus. And when they found Him, they said, "Everyone's looking for you." Jesus answered and said, "Let's go to nearby towns and villages, and I will see people and preach there. That is why I have come." So Jesus traveled all around Galilee, preaching and teaching and healing people. People today are still looking for Jesus, and they're looking for Him because they need something that only He can give. Forgiveness for sin, everlasting life, peace, comfort. Are we looking for Jesus? I think we are, even if we don't recognize that in our everyday. In the Bible, it says, if we search for Him with all our heart and soul, we can find Him. We can find Him in the Bible when we read. We can find Him when we watch Mass or go to Mass. Jesus is there and He's waiting for us. So this week, boys and girls, I challenge you to look for Jesus in your everyday life, in the people that you meet. He's there and He's waiting for us to open our hearts for Him. Let's close in prayer. Dear Father, we know that many people are still looking for You today. Help us to find You in all the people that we meet and to share You with those that we love and those who we meet. We thank You for this day and we love You. Amen. Thanks for joining me, boys and girls, and have a wonderful week. Bye.